Good morning, class. Miss Sam here. How are you feeling today? So, for today's lesson, we're gonna learn on formal letter, English language year 6, unit 9, a article. Make sure to open up your textbook, page 88. Okay, guys. These are the picture of page 88. Make sure you are in the right book. You guys, are you guys ready? Good. What is formal letter? A formal letter is a letter written in formal language. It has a specific structure and layout. Let's discuss on the first part, which is a letter written in formal language. What does it mean? Here is the example I've taken from the book. The answer or the written form should be short and sweet. And it also must be focused. If you can see the writing here, I am writing to inform you that my son Najmi bin Naim will not be able to attend the co-curricular activities on Wednesday, 20th of June. Najmi will be attending his brother's graduation in Penang. I hope you will excuse him. So, this one is focusing on the main part of the subject here, which is asking permission to be absent. So, you see, this is very short and formal language. Next, a specific structure and layout. When you write formal letter, the letter should be in structure and be laid out as it's stated here. It must have sender address, date, receiver address, salutation, subject, body, complementary closure, signature, and sender's name. This must be in a manner you cannot change into a different form. If you change into the different form, it's gonna be informal letter. So, remember, formal letter must be written in a structure form like this. Who should you send the formal letter to? Because formal letter cannot be simply sent to others. You, as a sender, send the letter to receiver, mostly to your teachers, bank personnel, company, and local council. The reason? To seek permission, to complain, and to apply job. So, if you want to send a letter to a friend saying hi, informal letter is the best way. So remember, formal letter should be sent to the person such as teachers, bank, company, or local council. Let's talk about the second point, which is a specific structure and layout. Okay, when you write a formal letter, you should be in structure and in such manner. You cannot simply write the letter in your own way. It must have this part. What are the parts I'm talking about? So you must be confused, right? So, it has to be in layout and specific manner, like I told you before. So, when you want to write the formal letter, you should have part by part. Part 1 is the sender address, which means your address. Make sure you write your long name here and also your address here. It's not long name, sorry, it's full name. Sorry. Okay, next, part 2. You must have the date. Write the date of today. For example, if you write the letter today. But if you write the letter on another day, date that you write this letter. Next, part 3. Receiver address. who's the receiver of this letter? Do you want to write to your teacher? So simply use the examples given. But if you write to another person, so you have to write his full name and then his address. Next, salutation. For example here, dear Encik Hakimi. If you know the receiver name, you write dear and the receiver name. If you don't know the person, you simply write yes sir or dear madam. Next, write the subject, which is part 5. You have to write the subject of the letter. For example, this one. Permission to be absent from co-curricular activity. So if you want to complain about what? For example, you want to complain about the untidiness of a toilet, for example. The toilet is spoiled. Okay, complain about school toilet. 6. The body of the letter. Your letter, like I told you, your written letter must be short and focused. Part 7. Complimentary closure. If you know the receiver, it is advisable if you write yours sincerely. If you don't know the receiver, advisable for you to write yours faithfully. Okay? Next. Part 8. The easiest part. Signature. Don't forget to sign there. Part 9, sender's name. Make sure you write your full name. Okay? Reminder to all, make sure you leave one space for each part or section. Except for the last two parts, which is signature and then sender name, no need to write, no need to leave a space. But the rest, make sure you leave a bit gap there. Homework for today is your writing activity. Writing in your English too. So what you need to do is to write a short and sweet formal letter. Imagine you are asking father or mother you would like to seek permission for asking to absent from school for 2 days. So what's the subject you can write? Permission to be absent from school for 2 days. That's it. A very short and sweet, simple subject. I will share this activity in your WhatsApp group. If you have any questions, do contact me through WhatsApp and personal message. Okay, guys! Don't worry, if you have any problem, do contact me. Bye. See ya.